people just come down early and set up themselves with their towels and just get a towel and I'm just gonna throw back myself. You just put on a slipper. Yes, and everything. Everybody done. You see we're going and you come down early? And people just put the thing and take it up. Take up everything. I can just go and sit down at the bar. They can't stop me from sitting at the bar. And to start your day with this is just amazing to start your day like this. Come out. Okay. And look at this. It's just amazing. Just super amazing. Yeah? You know, you come out and start your day with this. You know? Beautiful fresh air. Alright, let me get down to brass tacks. So see, somebody sent a video to me. Somebody sent a video to me. Of somebody stealing an excavator. So I'm here and I'm thinking, how can we do something like this back home? So the bar here, you come, you drink whatever you want, right? Now you would have families, people who fairly wealthy are, that would come, and before they come here, they're thinking how much they could eat and how much they could drink. It's like, I was telling Gavi yesterday, if we were to open a resort like this in Guyana, we'd have to train a whole generation of people. You know what I'm saying? Because you'd get a set of people with a low life mentality. They'd come and eat and drink up and shit up and piss up the whole fucking blue place. I'm thinking, I'm looking at it. I'm asking myself, how? No, bear in mind, the parts of Mexico are the rough. So obviously something is working in this area, the way the people are trained. If you go to the entertainment last night, Coco Bongo was just amazing. Now, the difference with the amazingness of all that's going on here and me is that I've matured in a certain way that doesn't really allow me to get excited as a kid would get excited, right? OC and no. I went out last night, I had to left the bias. Remember these banners? All these banners there in the early 30s, some of them even reach 30. Right? This kid to me, he's a 4-year-old man. I sit down at Coco Bongo, I'm looking. Well, baby, it's not civilized. I'm only assuming that the people working here, the hardships living in some slum they ain't living in. You can't sustain a facility like this with very rich people working here. These people are not rich people, right? But the people have a certain level of discipline. They have a certain understanding. So we would have to train a whole generation of people to be able to do things like, because remember, here we got pay attention. You open a facility like this, is Guyanese you expecting to serve? There's never Guyanese alone come to get entertainment, because I don't think most of the people here are Mexican. A lot of Spanish speakers here, but most of the people here are not Mexican. If you look at the people who work here, they got a Amerindian, Mexican kind of look. But if you look at the visitors, these are foreigners. Yes, sir. So, I am talking about the service provision. Even when you go to Barbados, people are, hello, sir. Thanks and please and thank you and these kind of things, right? So I'm thinking you got to train a whole generation. Right? Like imagine you going to Guyana and the whore you got picked for is fatter. Wait. It does the options. Yes, eh? It's like I've been out last and if you see them prostitutes, you want to pick up some of them and go marry this gun. Yes, eh? You imagine the option for fucking fear picking in Guyana. The top of work or what Guyana got for half is fatter. God, this. No, not beating up on her, but yes, eh? It's where fucking prostitution come to. Right? So, I'm telling you. So any... No, Sean, I didn't... Let me tell you. Let me tell you what's my problem. So, when I done book the ticket and there, on my way over here, I'm thinking this is the longest I would have gone on different trips, different country. And I'm thinking, is this, I study this music with, I don't want this music to fudge me up. That's me problem. I don't want this music to fudge you up. Let me move from next to this music because it might cut me live. Yeah. Everybody take a setup and just relax it. Yeah. We're good. At a nice spot and sit down. Yeah. Now, bear in mind, there are a lot of hardships in Mexico, right? Mexico ain't perfect. Terrible place, certain parts, but this is a piece of heaven in Mexico. How do we do that? We ain't got nothing, you know. Clifton and Marriott come the closest to any kind of farm or proper entertainment we got. How do we? Oh, sorry. It's all over this music there. I want it. Closer to me. Yeah. Right? So we're far away from the music. So yeah. I'm gonna clear ring and a proper. From here gonna get breakfast. Yeah. So Clifton sleeping. Princess Ramadia, Princess Hotel, right? All of these got thing. We got Iracramo. You got a lot of resorts. You got ranches, Viking Ranch and all them ranches. Lots of places to go in Guyana. But I'm looking at the... No, here was the funny thing. Is tannable is the word, like trainable. If you go to a resort where the Amerindians have been training tourism just a discipline, the black and Indians, you go to a place where they are service providers, a set of fucking attitude. There's a set of attitude like not disdain. Like they're overconfident. They don't realize you gotta work for the money. You gotta work for the money. You understand? You're providing a service. You're not belittling yourself. People work hard for the money and come handing their fucking money to you now for bring drinks for me and do this for me and do that for me, take care of me. You understand? It's a job. You ain't doing nobody no fucking favor. And people can get drunk and do stupidness. I got a video, I got to show you all the video. The girl come to a shot in my mouth. Then shake my head, so I pull up my shirt and play with my body. That is a thing at Senior Frog. Frogs. Next to Coco Bongo. There's a thing. Some of them they shake your turn around the man and take the knee and wrench it in the ass like if it's a backball they get in. Yes, and you got me. I never experienced no girl raising up me top and playing with me, Bobby. What are you gonna do? Cuss up and behave bad? You understand? So we're talking about this. We find the truck operator, somebody in Cerro Johanna, that carry with the people in excavator. So we walk in line with the police, and when I get the exact name, I say we gotta do some exposing. You understand? Because I want to get the details first. Because sometimes the like Michael does get hired for gonna move things, right? But it's people we know. But even if somebody come and tell me they can give me a money for move an excavator, when I go they start the fucking excavator and moving it and drive it up on me truck, what I must do? Not to say when the police start investigating I ain't gonna get a problem and I gotta get answer how I end up there, why what I'm doing. But yes, this is the way it goes. So the truck man who pick up the excavator, man go to pick up and all them things that you're seeing, the people clear, you know it's who, right? It's just that now they get exposed. And there's another video that's gonna go up on my page. It's with a fire truck driving with fire in the back. I don't know. Lots of wildfires, guys. Down in Guyana, yeah, take your time. Yeah, don't be lighting no rubbish. Poor people like to run with fire. Jesus Christ, oh God, it's a poor people thing. I can tell you, you don't go in nobody civilized yard and they're keeping up fucking thing and burning it. That is a poor people thing. Oh Jesus Christ, the only place you go. As he will like the hip hop. Hip hop a thing now, nah, but I'm not. Oh, son. They'll stop now, especially. Now, especially. It's dry season, El Nino down in Guyana. Stop. There was 1,000 fires reported, wildfires reported in Barbies alone, 1,000. The smog rassing up people. They had a fire broke loose yesterday, it covered, and last night, whole night it burned. Come on. Every time you pass, it is illegal also to burn in rubbish. Rubbish got, we got dump sites now. That don't happen no more. I should not have to wake up in the morning and they in Mexico and telling y'all about this. Hey, from them dry leaf and center. Granny Lake is a fucking crass. It's the 24th century. No, I don't burn nothing no more. Alright, Alex, enjoy Essequibo. Go to Jacobin's Hotel when you did Essequibo and Regina. You telling critics in you. You get good treatment. One of the owners actually they here with me. But you got your family there. Busy board there. So, let me tell you about. Okay, yes, super nice place. And Gabby traveled, the younger one, and the family in general travel a lot all over the world and all these resorts, so they know what it is for service provision. You understand? Right? So, I'm telling you. We got the fires we talk about. What else we got covered? We got the people that thief the truck. Yeah, look at the video if anybody got any information. 622-7740. We got a fair idea we're going on. And there's $1 million rewards. Everybody's sending in information. We got to make sure we get the excavator. When we get the excavator, then we know who thing. And from the looks of this, we might get a boss up this morning. And I also holding the people, them who with the excavator, because they should come, they send the information, they may put up how they give me the information. So they're going to give $1 million reward. You can't tell me and get him not something I ain't getting. So last night, it was amazing. And this is what you got to learn about yourself. So I don't like being a spouse group. Ten years ago, I would have fucking party. I'd have been partying until now, blackout. So I had a pineapple something, big land thing. I danced a little bit, we had fun at Froggy's, we went to Coco Bongo, an amazing show. I've never been to anything like that. That's my first experience of Coco Bongo. It was amazing. It's something you could take your family, you, your girlfriend could go to, and you'd be blown away. It is, you know, being someone that has a love for the arts, and I'm going, I'm there and I'm seeing, it's like a circus. Acrobats and, you know, so much actors and everything. It was amazing. Now, the crew that I'm moving with is a rum sport crew. Them boys young, they got a whole life ahead of them, they enjoy life. I see myself when I was 25 in them. Right? It's just not my thing. Last time I go, we go to another place opposite from Coco Bongo, and I'm there, and everybody's there, and they're fucking loud. I got me crew. Wisely, when I go out, we go, we do the same thing in Suriname. The last time I went to Suriname with me crew, we drinking. Caprice. The Brazilian national drink. All over we did. You get a little high answer. But this real party hard thing, I'm not. Like, I'm sitting here and I'm thinking, how do I build a resort like this? How much money is there to be made? I count all the fucking rooms. I've been in the pool. I count all the rooms. I'm looking at what it's gonna cost to run something like this on a daily basis. How do you get financing? You gotta get 10 people together. You gotta get 100 investors together. How do you do this? Then when I'm sitting on thinking, then we gotta go on to train a whole generation. Or do you bring in people from all over the world, from the tourism sector, get the, even to India. When I stayed at, when I went to the Taj Hotel in India, New Delhi, service provision, Barbados, Trinidad, because they're into this tourism. So we gotta get going. Iguana, you're gonna get at Jagdish. Jagdish, you can get some iguana. Alex, ask anybody where Jagdish is, and I don't know if they got I don't know if they got coconut choco, right? But Jagdish in Lima. Jagdish, ask anybody where Jagdish is. Ask anyone them taxi driver. They got all kind of curry in there. Jagdish is award-winning curry makers. Yeah, so I'm here. And I'm in the club, and this is a fucking little place on a corner that them people got it locked off. Man, Alex, jump in a fucking taxi and go. Alex, don't start misconduct this man. Jump in a taxi and go. You like a fucking baby. You got baby. Sit your mother's scunt and hold your hand and carry your baby. Or you want everybody to know your fucking story. Just jump in a taxi, tell you I want to go Jagdish. And go and enjoy your fucking self. It's just the same kind of fucking people we're talking about here right now. You understand? You can't help your fucking self. Me and I gonna get training for do service, but I ain't gotta stay up in the office and because I ain't even dealing with that like fucking y'all. Me, I talking about opening a resort. Me, I talking about opening a fucking old people home. Where I got whole people, I got push your mother's cunt in wheelchair all the fucking time. They know what for do, when for do, how for fucking do, when for talk, when not for talk. You know what I tell you where for go. You fucking want, no, you want a number.
when I gotta be entertaining your fucking telephone operator and everything. Me and I gotta get you, cause I can. Well, me, I gotta get you, Alex, and gotta get fucking you, cause he like fucking uncivil. Like he fucking uncivilized. You understand? This is what he's talking about. When you got Guyanese, like he for fucking deal with. Get in it. You got the fucking people them, yeah, like I said, he by the people them buffy. But we got, we you see fucking see gonna walk and see money stunt. Like here, you see, you know, you buy two drink for a Guyanese man, you buy two drink for a girl, you want to get it out of scumbag, they want married and that kind of fucking thing. Wait and see, them don't know about dating and them fucking thing. Yes, sir. Chigana, you stay at Main Street. Alex, when you like, you're on a fucking. You like you're on a stretch money vacation. You hear what I'm telling you? When you want anything, you get anything in this world that you want, then you're willing to spend your money. Don't go fucking place if you got money. One of them I'm running people right wrong there. You give them a $10,000 run and go and run up a fucking tree and bring you one for your career. You understand? It's money. It's money that's ruling the world. So I'm telling y'all now. Right? I got into this place last night. Them boys having a good time. The thing is, they dep on a level that mean dep on. Right? Them buy full rum sport itation. Enjoying the service. Gabby's birthday. I'm glad he enjoys it. I enjoy myself. They might not have seen it on my face because I didn't overdrive. I study in a man at a little club on a car. Like everybody just stand up. And I can't tell how much money this man making it. You understand? This time, me crew wise, really didn't know. Before they be sit down, say, eh, this is nice. How we set up, how we can make some money, or whatever. Or you can care about something like this. Because it's all about the entertainment. You got a DJ, got everybody dancing, you got people doing the thing, walking and lying behind one another. You're just having a ball. You understand? You got to come up with ideas to keep people entertained. You know, people hustling for going this place. And I am thinking, what if I'm going out here? Alex asking how he could get there. Scumbag. You up now. How much more time I got by this man? I'm gonna be a shot. It's only half an hour, daddy. Any of them scoundrels, like. You see, Alex got some fucking security work somewhere. Yes, and it's only security master ship it's gone by. Alex, you got to be doing a fucking security work somewhere, by. You got to be some. You can't be no fucking. Profession with a techno intellect banner. You got to be a fucking security guard, by. You can't be in no profession with a tech a certain level of academia, forgetting. You understand what I'm telling you? Use a different level of fucking shepherd, by. There was. Alex, do you fucking think my baby? this. And imagine the man travel. Dumb man travel. But I would want to feel Alex is live outside and come Guyana and tour an island. You know, the man will get last between four fucking chairs and a table. Oh, God! Hey, hey, I ain't easy, boy. I ain't easy. So I'm telling you, right? You don't have to do, like, peer pressure don't apply to me. Like them bad critic drink. Yo, I good. Yeah, so last night, when the midst of the session going on, when my partner to me body, I wish she happy body because we waited for 12 o'clock. Because since 11 o'clock, I want to roll out. Yes, I wait for 12 o'clock, wish you happy body, take some drinks with you. Right? And that's not me, body. I is all in. Right? I just drink rum sport kind of banana too. And I sit down and I sip. This restaurant, I start the steak restaurant. I think I'm going to do a steak this morning. I wonder if they got a nice steak. Yeah, they got a steak restaurant. So, yes, you need a, you need a visa to come to Mexico. You could go to, the visa is between Boyce Place on Brickdam. The Mexican embassy is on Brickdam, so you could go there. Right? Bills, I might explain again because that's the purpose of it. Eh? Alexis, what kind of work you do, man? What kind of work you do? Honestly, what kind of work you do? I'm trying to get an understanding of how your thought processes work. You understand? Kesh, morning. Drew, good morning. Randy, I am a supervisor for Amazon. Nah. Don't do me the man, Alex. Here, listen to me. I is a high school dropout, partner. But I exceptionally smart, partner. You not operating at no supervision fucking level, bro. You hear what I tell you? You up at a kindergarten level. You either doing security work or mapping some fucking thing. You ain't using your brain for do whatever you're doing, partner. Don't do me that, Alex. Don't do me that. I would got in your profile and hunt your scum and find out where you're working on Allen. You can't be no supervisor for nothing. Especially Amazon. We will deal with packages and Allen thing. You ain't know to find a fucking place. You know for find out. You ain't know for fucking use Google. Man, Alex, don't do me that this morning, man. Oh God, I'll go meet you, I'll shame scunt for hear you say so, partner. You supervising the Amazon Warriors? You're not operating on no super, this is the fucking thing. The guy around them always tell me he's a super, right? He doing the cleaning, he walking at the building. Empire State, they're walking at some fucking building. Esther know what you're talking about, man. Right away, partner. Who use damp and this thing and them question we use asking. You can't operate on a no supervision fucking level, man. You brain immature enough for get supervision work, partner. With Amazon? If Amazon is making people like you fucking supervisor, we never get a package answer today. You know, for do little research with Google, you always the perscont, you understand? You gotta show me you pay slip or something, man. No, I would apologize to you publicly, Alex. I telling you. It's just from me assessment, I is a good judge of character, buddy. You ain't operating at no supervision level. Except Amazon hire you based on inclusivity and they want to put a certain amount of fucking retarded people. So we hire retarded people, we hire black people, we hire Indian people. Where's Scarlett, man, affirmative action or something like that, yes? Because you fucking supervision material, Bano. I could only imagine me, you rolling, and I gotta tell you where to put the bag and where. That would trip me, scunt, but. So, no, don't take here. Here was one of me. I can't take stupidity, you know. I can't take stupid people. I try, oh God, I try. I can't take stupid people at all. I got real disdain for stupid people. Yes, eh? You got smart, you got sharp as something there on me, buddy. Oh God, the sun is beautiful. Now the sun coming out here. It's a little cloudy outside here. Yeah. So what will we have to cover? I'm telling y'all. Amazon warehouse, none of them little warehouse tip topper. Nobody like fucking Alex there on there. Alex looks like the kind of man that close he fucking a door on his finger. He's closing a door with one hand and forget he got to take out the other hand. Man operating at a different level. He there, how we gonna reach there, how we gonna go there, how. Alex is them kind of man and they go, so where's the exchange? Where the fuck is the exchange? Right here, but the exchange rate. How are you spending? Are you spending? You know? People outside, they work for the money, they work for the US money, and then when they come back, it's just the, how much is this? How much is that? Are you spending the money? Are you spending the money? Yeah, telling you. So, when I look at, I'm here and I'm sitting, I'm thinking what President Ali is doing, how the country is being developed. And I realize the big problem is not that only there's a white cross-section of Guyanese that ain't developed the mentality to fit in or to keep up with the development that is happening. You also have people like the opposition, like Norton, whose whole sole intention is to keep this cross section of Guyanese just the way they are. That is worrying. Yes, I know. If people got shortcomings and we try to mold them differently, it's a different thing. But when you got people, the training people to maintain shortcomings, yes, teaching people how to stay and suffer. Because I like this resort here. Outside here alone, I think this resort hire about 1,000 people. I went to the club last night, one of the clubs last night, and I got about 50 people outside selling tickets alone. Just for getting inside. Coco Bongo got about 100 people outside. Wait, you go, hey, Coco Bongo, you party, you? When I come out to Coco Bongo, hey, strip club, a lady got a picture showing you a girl's skin up. So, strip club, punani. Girls. When I jump in the taxi last, well, I left them boys. I cannot make it. Them boys come home this morning. You don't have to hear the half of the story. And somebody tell me this morning what happened in Mexico, left in Mexico. You understand? Me let them sleep and so. Right? I hear a fucking thing tumbling in the dark. I said, bye, you want light? The man said, no. I said, what is man got night vision? The man drink till he get fucking night vision. Because I can't see. Me see he, but he moving in the dark. And licking down everything in the room. I said, bye, you want light? He said, no, he want light. Right? So, you can imagine how they drunk last night. Me left early. Me left early. Me come, me gotta get me rest. Me can't make that. Right? I sit on here thinking. How for make more, how for do something like that, how you could create jobs. You understand? How we could create jobs back home, how are you gonna train the people? Because nothing is impossible. Right? Nothing is impossible. But you gotta identify the problem, 50% of the solution is identifying the problem. If you don't know what your problem is, you're 100% in a problem. Right? Satyawati. S-A-T-Y-A-W. Satyawati. Vani Ragobir. Hey, buddy. You good?
How are you?
Morning. Cool, man. Yeah.
Today I work in here.
Oh, today you work inside?
Over there.
Oh, in the bar there?
Uh-huh.
All right, I'll come check you out. Looking for you to tell you where they work here. Because when we drop the tip on them, man, can't get in here. Yeah, them over the fucking crazy here and the other, the crew is there with you. That man is like, we did the bar down. Remember, everything is all inclusive, right? But they got to be, oh, here was the next thing. Bye. We there in a club, Ram Jam. And every 5 minutes, somebody come. In Guyana, you're looking for fucking people. If you go to Tribe, and pan every fucking minute you're looking for somebody. This place ramp here, the place where we went in last, I didn't got no place in Guyana like that. And every minute, 5 minutes, somebody coming. Now bear in mind, it's free drinks they give you. You pay and they give you a band, you got in. Right? It's free drinks. Every minute somebody come in and nice you up. The band there yesterday, we did the bar down there. Remember, they gotta look after everybody. White people, they got people from India, they got people from all over the world there. But when you get a man a nice tip, who you believe they're taking care of better than anybody else? You understand? Like the man see me there. So I said, I did this bar inside here, you got the next bar. You understand? He said, go make something interesting for me. Right? It's live and let live, it's love. But I can tell you, even the people, because here, them man come in every 5 minutes with drinks. So you're getting drinks. So some white man was asking, how are you getting service so fast? It's just we getting faster, but I'm telling you, the poorest service here better than the best service in Guyana. Because in Guyana, it's got, even Marriott, it's got waiting for people looking for people calling, there's gone. Four people there in the counter. In Marriott, when you go to the bar, four, five people there inside, and you got eyes got watching them, showing them, so come steady. You understand? These people just prepare for action and are real service providers. I think I can take it early today and I'm just going to eat this steak. Good morning, everybody. Shirley, good morning. So, yeah, this is one of the things I noticed when I went in the place last night. It's like an outdoor, it's a car and a club, right? Them man come with drinks. Them man throw shots. Fui. And the shots they're long, but you know what? The man come throw away the shots and go and bring more shots. Think they long open, but the man come get rid of it and give you a fresh thing for drink. Beer get hot, but the because it's beers and cups. The man throw it out and bring fresh thing for you. And this place ram jam, you got for squeeze for go through. You understand? That man just know how to keep a party going and entertain people. So we gotta look at how do we do that? How do we replicate things like this in Guyana and really become, you know, it is not. You gotta look at things for what they are. Just like how the blacks are predominantly in the public sector, I'm looking. I don't know if how many of you would have had the experience of going into the interior and going to like Viking Ranch and Erakrama, the Canopy Walk. Erakrama also has a Canopy Walk. Or any community where Holy and Sully's Amerindians are the service providers. Once they're trained, and I'm looking at the as you know, the Mexicans are brothers to our Amerindians. Because it's the Bering Strait we would have come across. That's how you reach down to, you know, the Americas coming down to South America. And so that's how we spread all across the world. And I'm thinking, you know, our Amerindian brothers and sisters have gone into a lot of different fields. The men them going off and going in the bush and looking for money, leaving the women. I'm thinking, seriously, this is the kind of things the Amerindians got to capitalize on. Service provision. Because the Amerindians have a very cool, it's just when they drink up the rum, but they have a very cool, presentable demeanor. Black and Indian people, got fucking attitude. Like they entitled to something. You understand? Now the women them, these modern day women, got an over-inflated sense of self and their fucking importance. You understand? This time when you go out in the world and watch, like watch Fata and watch Spanish, them Spanish guys. You understand? Fata can't even get fucking nice when you get drunk. And when you get drunk, anybody's get nice. Not beating up a shit, but this is the reality. You understand? Nobody looking for, if you're moving up, nobody looking for ghetto. Right? Let me go. I get last time I got the thing. I tell him I want a hat. I come at 1 o'clock this morning. But I tell you, I get away from the bison, right? Because that's not me. That's not me anymore. Honestly, it's if and I see some big men in Guyana, right? Like they know the time and the place. That's not me, buddy. That's not me. Tomorrow I got to do more early. I get a little half of the time. I woke up early, but just the time difference got me busy. Confused me terribly. I got to set my watch and stuff. So you guys take care. We got to look at and look at the perspectives of how do we use the amazing thing that we learning all over the world back home. Man, I got some construction material up top here, this thing. We gotta get some construction material for what we doing at Bellevue for the defenses them and so. Hey, guys, take care. Peace and love. I dig you. You're rolling.